fun here. I got a whole bunch of different kinds of paints and just mixed it to a kind of this kind of consistency, as you can see. So it's kind of drippy. I'm gonna put the black up here and wait till you see what happens. This is so cool. So go like that. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get this paper and I'm gonna just pretty much just smear it from top to bottom. Let's see what kind of effects it does. I've never done this before. So let's see what happens. So start like that. Hold on. So I'll get my piece of paper like that, holding it quite thick like that. And actually, I don't even feel like I have a good grip on it. So here, that's better. And I'm gonna rub it down like that, let's see what happens. Look at that, so cool. Wow, I love it. Look at that. Beautiful. Turn on my little blaster. It's on. You hear it? There we go. Just add a few more cells. They really pop up here at the top. You have to move very quickly so you don't burn it. Okay. Let's see what happens now if I move it just a bit. Starting to see light, and I like that because I don't want it all black. I prefer more of the blue colors and the different gorgeous colors that they have here. I'm going to try to blast it again. This is one messy job. If you're going to do it with your child, just be prepared to get very, very messy. Blast again. Just kind of fussing a little, just seeing. See what happens when you're a little bit obsessive compulsive. You're just not quite happy with how it might be quite yet. So you're always trying to make it a little bit better. And that's what I'm going to do here. Here's my little needle. I'm going to try this. And it's getting wet. There we go. Again, the weird thing is you don't want to fuss too much with this at this point because it's going to do its magic. You don't want to, you know how, was it Bob Ross always used to say about happy accidents? And this is one of those things where you feel indeed has an amazing happy accident. Just as a result of how the paints chemically react to each other. So, let's see what happens here. Oopsie. Move really quickly when you do this, or you'll actually start seeing the paint cook. Wow. All these new cells are developing. That's about it. That's about it. So, Let's just wait and see what happens here. What it looks like. And if you like this, please feel free to click a yes on my YouTube and let me know what else you would like to see in the future. Okie doke. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna try to see what happens if I add a little bit of more pink to it, because I love this pink color, but I don't want to put a ton. So I'm gonna just do a little drops here and there. Really small little drops. Because this is cool. I like this. It almost looks like little flowers. Some people actually have seen on videos where people actually glow and they make kind of unique and different designs with the flowers, but I don't think I want to do it this time. That I don't want to do. But I'll add a little more. There we go. Okay, so we did that. Behind the string, which you kind of wear in by default, is you have to make sure it's well soaked, it's sort of well seated and weighted into your painting. If it's not, it's just going to slide and make a kind of a bit of a mess. So that's kind of important to take into account when you do this. You can imagine if you had a really large canvas and you did this, how cool this might look. What I tend to do at this point is I could use this little prickly thing and just make sure it's nicely seated in the picture. And this is when I just might have to try this to add this to it. I'm not crazy about that color. Maybe a little bit of a pink. Here, this one I like. I love this color so much. I have to add a little bit here and there. Just run a little like that. Very cool. God, I almost want to do another one. What do you think?
It's quite
beautiful. Well, let's think about it.